morning, guys. So welcome back to my channel. Today I just started my day on OBGYN. This is my going into my third week. So I wanted to record today because I just found out, I just found out we have someone who's currently in labor about 6 centimeters and we have a C-section scheduled, but I'm in the office right now because we could do clinic and the hospital. So we're actually gonna leave from the clinic just to go right down the street. So first we'll see what's going on in the office today, but yeah, just have a little office back here. And then I usually go up front and like study in between patients. So we'll see. I'm so excited. So I'll update you guys when I can. So I am leaving the office now. It's about a minute, maybe 2 minute drive to the hospital. So the first one is just a regular vaginal delivery. So I'm just gonna go there, go and check on the patient, basically like round on her. The nurse will be in there because the nurse is usually there the whole time. Once the woman starts dilating, the nurse will be in there with them. And I think hopefully the C-section will be ready. I think we'll probably just do it right after. I change into their scrubs there. So at the clinic, I wear scrubs and a white coat. In the hospital, I wear the OR scrubs. So I go, I change into the OR scrubs on the OB floor, leave my stuff in there, and then basically, you know, round, do the procedures, and then when I leave, I just change back into my clothes and then either go back to clinic, depending on what time it is, or go home or stay and study until if someone else is in labor. So how it works on OB is tell me when he has deliveries and C-sections, but I'm always welcome to go on another doctor's service. So, you know, if I go to the hospital at 7:30 in the morning, and I'm always able to like jump in with another physician doing a C-section. So everyone's super nice. Okay guys, I just got to the hospital parking garage. I don't even know what floor I'm on, but I don't even know why I'm taking my backpack, to be honest, just in case. So I'm walking, I'm gonna go try and find how to get in where I need to go because I haven't come in from this back parking garage. Okay, so I'm all changed. I'm gonna be taking this because it gets messy in OBGYN. So, yep, here we go. I'm gonna go see the patient. Okay guys, so a quick update on the delivery that I just did. The baby actually came out with a midline defect and I just wanted to update you guys. And then I just saw another delivery. Patient was super nice, let me come in there. Wasn't my doctor that I was with, but the doctor was great and super helpful. And that delivery was easy and everything went well. I go chill at the nurse's station and read and study until doc gets here. Maybe go check on the patient and see how she's doing. So yeah. All right guys, so just finished with the C-section. So, you know, they started her on methergen and basically just waited for the uterus to contract to deliver the placenta to not have any complications or hemorrhaging, and so it went really well. So I ended up seeing 4 deliveries today, total 2, 1 C-section, no, I can't even remember. 3 deliveries, 1 C-section. So now I'm just gonna go back to the nurse's station, see what, and see if they need any help with anything, the nurses or the doctors. I just kind of offer a helping hand to anyone. Just introduce myself, start talking to people, make connections. Okay guys, so it is about 4 o'clock and I am just now leaving the hospital. So I got into clinic around like 8:45, stayed in clinic till about 10. Just like doing routine visit stuff, some annuals. We did an endometrial biopsy this morning and then got called up. So now it is about 4 o'clock and I'm leaving. I did, like I said, 4 total deliveries, 1 C-section, 3 vaginal. It ended up being semi-busy. You know, I was constantly in a delivery today, even though there was only 4 from like 10 a.m. to 4 o'clock. But I'll be going back in tomorrow. C-sections start at 7:30 that are scheduled. They start at 7:30 in the morning. So I'll show up here tomorrow at 7. If nothing's going on, I'll head over to clinic and, you know, have a day in clinic. Hey, good morning, guys. It is 6:45 in the morning. I'm running a little behind. I have to be at the hospital in like 15 minutes. So C-sections start at 7:30. I just wanted to come on here and say good morning. I'm already in my OR scrubs to limit some time. I'm gonna need to change. So let's go. Okay, so now I'm running extra late because I actually had to go home because I forgot my badge. So we'll see what's going on. All right, guys, I just got out of another C-section. Went really well. I'm actually gonna go check on another patient that was 10 centimeters dilated before I went into the C-section. So let's go see how she's doing. All right, guys, so I'm out of red light, but that delivery was finished. It is so cold here in Jacksonville today. Whoa, there's my steering wheel. But I am headed over to clinic right now for the rest of the day until 4:30, unless we get another delivery or there's another C-section. So yeah, so basically what we can do in the office is colposcopies, endometrial biopsies, you know, IUD insertion and removal, annual exams, everything that you would think of when you go to a OBGYN, and then obviously OB checks. So like I was talking about earlier, you can check the cervix, you can do the GBS culture. There's a lot of things you can do, check the size of the uterus and things like that. So I guess I will just keep you guys updated with that. It's good morning. So I didn't end up filming the rest of the day yesterday. When I got back to the office, our system shut down, so we didn't really see that many patients, but another morning, so it's 6:45, I'm gonna go to the hospital now. Hopefully we have a C-section at 7:30. If not, I know another doctor does, so let's go. Okay guys, been kind of busy, so we did two C-sections this morning, just saw two vaginal deliveries, so busy day today. It's about 12:30 now, been here since 6:45. Everything's going well, busy day. It is 4:00. I've literally seen like 5 deliveries and 3 or 4 C-sections, and I'm going in for another C-section. So today has ended up being a crazy busy day. I'm so happy I came to the hospital today. Yeah, so we'll see what happens. It's 7:00 and I'm finally leaving. I think there was like 9 or 10 total deliveries today. So these have been really like longer hours for me compared to all my other rotations so far. And I've just really been enjoying it. And, I know I say this about every rotation, but these people are just so willing to teach. Like the nurses and the surgical techs and everybody has just been, they've all been so amazing. But this is a good time to say, you know, I don't have to stay there for 12 hours. You know, the doctor I'm with has a couple procedures and then leaves and either goes to clinic or goes home. Today was one of the days that our clinic was closed. So I literally stayed at the hospital all day. I got there at 6:45 this morning and at 7 at night. But it's a good time to say, you know, take advantage, and this is how you can make the most of your rotations. So I have just been jumping on other doctor's services if they'll let me, and they've been just taking me under their wing and really making my education so much better. There was nothing scheduled, and then we ended up having like 10 deliveries total today. So it's been crazy, and I'm just so happy that I stayed, you know, even though I didn't have to. So always do that. Always go the extra mile. People will see it, you know. It matters, and like I said, you get to see the most. If you put more time in, you reap the benefits for sure. I just really love this rotation. I could do this every day and just show you guys what my days are like, but I don't want to bore you. So I figured a couple days of filming would be good. I think I ended up doing about 3 days. So normally I'll split, you know, hospital clinic time, but today was just a really good day to just stay in the hospital all day and meet all the different people and just get so much experience and so much learning today. So I'm super thankful for that. And I'm just really, really loving this rotation. And it just makes my heart so happy. I don't know. I just love it. I love kids. I love babies. So yes. Okay. So I literally just got home. Don't mind. I'm so tired, but a good tired. I'm just so happy. Yeah, just ignore that. But I just wanted to go ahead and end the vlog and just say, you know, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope these help you. I love answering all your guys' questions and kind of bringing you guys along when I can remember. I filmed a couple days for you guys. I think I got like 3, maybe like 2.5 days. This rotation, I have gotten so much time to learn and be there. Like I have consistent and continuous hours on this rotation, which I love. Like I want to be tired. I want my body to hurt like this. But I'm actually going to eat something because it's, what time is it? It's almost 7:30, so I'm gonna eat something, but I just wanted to say thank you, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit subscribe so you can at least see when I upload videos, and I hope to see you guys on the next one.